Today, we take a look at how we're modernizing the experience for SharePoint and OneDrive admins, along with additional security and compliance controls. I will show you the redesigned SharePoint Admin Center that brings all the information you need in one place and makes tasks like site management much easier. How you can now control user session lengths on unmanaged devices. And if you're a multinational organization, I will show you how you can store your data in different regions or countries and apply differentiated policies. And finally, how to get ultimate control over your data by using your own encryption keys. As we looked at how to make SharePoint and OneDrive for business administration better, we have focused on three main areas. First, giving you a modern experience that helps you get your job done faster. Secondly, ensuring that you have the right controls to keep your data safe. And lastly, expanding the options you have to meet your compliance needs. The new SharePoint Admin Center is tailored specifically to your needs as a SharePoint admin. It is one single place for you to manage everything related to SharePoint. The landing page shows you the most important information about your tenant. As you can see, we're making SharePoint information that was previously only available to global admins now available to you as a SharePoint admin. On this page, you will see insights and usage about your tenant. You can see how many files are being viewed, synced. You can even see the amount of sharing activity happening in your organization. You can see the total number of SharePoint sites in your organization and how many are active. And these reports are interactive, so if you want, you can filter based on active sites. And if you want, you can always click on details to drill down further. So here, I'm looking at a 90-day view of my file activity. And if I want, I can even look at the user activity. This type of visibility into SharePoint usage and adoption enables you to take proactive actions and get more value out of your Office 365 subscription. Going back on the landing page, you will also find the Message Center, which keeps you appraised of the latest set of changes applied to your tenant so you can keep up with new capabilities lighting up for your users. As you can see, I have a message here informing me that OneDrive and SharePoint users are going to get a new sharing experience, so I can get ready for it right now. Additionally, the Service Health Dashboard provides you with the latest information about the health of your SharePoint service. As you can see here, everything is healthy right now, but in case there is an incident or advisory, it'll show up right here too. The new Admin Center also makes it easy to find what you're looking for. If I click on Site Management, you will notice that we have added a lot more site metadata that you can use to filter, sort, and quickly find the sites you're looking for. And the sites list now shows all the sites in your organization, including group team sites. So I'm now going to quickly filter based on templates, and I'm going to pick team site group template. And now you can see all the group team sites in my tenancy. I'm now going to clear the filter to go back and look at the whole list. And this time I'm going to filter based on classifications. In my organization, we have three classifications: high business impact, medium business impact, and low business impact. So here, I'm actually going to try and find all the sites that have not been classified. And if I want, I can contact the owners of these sites and ask them to apply classification to these sites. And now I'm going to go back, clear the classification filter, I'm back to my list, and this time I'm going to sort based on last activity. I'm trying to find all the sites that have not been used in a while. And once again, if I want, I can select these sites and contact the owners to figure out if maybe we should delete these sites. And in future, you'll also be able to create your own custom views. And finally, we're also simplifying the settings page to create logical groupings to make it easy to quickly find and change settings. So while the new SharePoint Admin Center brings you a beautiful modern admin experience, we're also continuing to focus on building richer conditional access policies to keep your data safe while keeping your users productive. SharePoint already offers conditional access policies that allow you to control the level of access from an unmanaged device and an untrusted network location. I've covered this before in detail on Microsoft Mechanics, and you can watch and learn more at the link below. We're now adding a new access policy that allows you to specify shorter session lengths when users access SharePoint or OneDrive from an unmanaged device. This is helpful if you have users that access content on the go from potentially insecure public devices or kiosks. Here, I'm setting the policy to force my users to re-authenticate after 15 minutes of inactivity on an unmanaged device, with the reminder after 10 minutes of inactivity. Once I set this policy, users are automatically logged out after the specified period of inactivity. Now let's switch gears to talk about new options to help with your compliance needs. A top request from those of you in large multinational companies has been the ability to store your data in different countries or regions to meet with your data residency and compliance needs. With multi-geo support in OneDrive for Business, you can go from a single primary location for storing your data to multiple locations across the globe and assign users to a specified location. While the user's OneDrive for Business files will reside in the location they're assigned to, they're able to seamlessly share and collaborate with others, both within and outside the organization. Let me show you how to enable this. In this case, I'm the admin of a multinational organization, and majority of my users are in North America and Europe, with some users in Asia. I can run a simple PowerShell command to extend my existing tenant to the Asia-Pacific region. As you can see, Asia-Pacific location has been added to my tenant. And now I can assign users to this location. So here I have assigned Sesha to the Asia location. And as an admin, I can also set policies per location. So here I am in the new OneDrive for Business Admin Center on the sharing page. I'm currently looking at the sharing settings for North America as indicated at the top of the page. Now let's say I want to allow external sharing everywhere except in Asia. I'm going to change my location to Asia Pacific, and I can disable external sharing just for the Asia Pacific location. I hit save, and then I'm going to go back to my North America location. So I'm going to change the location back to North America, and you will see that external sharing is still enabled in North America. So now let's see what does this look like from the user perspective. So here I am logged in as myself, Navjot. I'm a user in the North America location, and external sharing is enabled for me. So I'm going to select a file, I'm going to hit share, and I'm going to share this with Garth, who is an external partner we are working with. As you can see, I'm informed that Garth is outside my organization, but that is fine. I'm going to hit share. I was able to successfully share this document with Garth. Now let's see what is the experience for Sesha. Now remember, Sesha is a user in Asia location and external sharing is disabled for him. Sesha selects a document, he clicks on share, and he tries to share the document with Garth too, using Garth's outlook.com address. And as you can see, Sesha has just been informed that administrative policies don't allow sharing with people outside the organization. So Sesha cannot share with Garth. But on the other hand, if Sesha tries to share with me, I'm a user of the organization, I just happen to be in North America, and Sesha is allowed to share with me. I've just shown you how you can easily extend your tenancy to multiple locations across the globe to meet your data residency needs and apply differentiated policies per location. Providing you with better control over your data stored in our service is a continuous focus for us. We believe it is your data and you should have full control over it. You can now bring your own encryption keys to encrypt the data stored in SharePoint and OneDrive for Business. You control our access to these keys and can choose to revoke it at any time. Let me show you how this works. To get started, you need to upload your keys to Azure Key Vault and grant access to SharePoint Online Service. Once you give access to SharePoint Online Service, SharePoint will use these keys to encrypt your data stored in SharePoint and OneDrive for Business. Enabling service encryption using your keys is completely transparent to the user. As you can see, I as a user can continue to interact with my files stored in SharePoint and OneDrive for Business. So here, I can click on a file, I can open it in Word, and I can view and edit the file. In the event that you decide to leave our service, you can simply remove our access to these keys. It is important to note that once you revoke our access, the service will no longer be able to access this data. That means even your users will no longer be able to access files stored in SharePoint and OneDrive. So now, as that user, if I try to open the same document in Word again, you will notice that I get an error. Word cannot open that document because service does not have the keys needed to decrypt the data to show it in Word. Service encryption using customer keys gives you ultimate control, so you can make sure that in the event that you decide to leave our service, there's absolutely no way for anyone at Microsoft to access your data. So that was an overview of how we're improving the administration experience and strengthening the controls you have to protect your data and decide where it resides. The new SharePoint Admin Center ships later this year, and we will continue to add more functionality to make this experience better. The new conditional access policy to control session lengths on unmanaged devices will also ship later this year. And like I mentioned, soon you'll also be able to apply these policies to specific sites. Multi-geo support for OneDrive for Business will be released for preview in the next few months, and multi-geo support for SharePoint will follow later. Lastly, service encryption using customer keys is available in preview now. As always, please keep giving us your feedback on user voice to help us make managing SharePoint and OneDrive easier. Thanks for watching.